Okay, so your default, I'll take it as a yes, and I'll proceed with the discussion, right? Okay, so my name is Karthik Kharbanda. Okay, I graduated from IIC Bangalore in the year 2016, and since then, almost 2017, I've been teaching for GATE. All right, so today it's all about discussing your GATE 2020 solutions for the GATE 2020 computer science exam, right? Okay, so we'll not waste any more time and we'll start go into the solutions now. So first we'll take up the aptitude part. So this is the first question. Okay, so first five questions in aptitude are for 1 mark and the next five will be for 2 marks. So these are the set of 1 mark questions now. Okay, so let's read this. Raman is confident about speaking English dash 6 months as he has been practicing regularly the last 3 weeks. Okay, so see, practicing regularly, I think this part is easier to understand. Okay, practicing regularly dash the last 3 weeks. So usually you'll have for the last three weeks, okay, because he has been doing it and he is still doing this. Okay, so for the last 3 weeks he has been practicing a lot. Okay, so Raman is confident of speaking English in what? See, for 6 months? No, why would you speak English for 6 months? So this cancels B and C option, right? Now option A, during 6 months? No, during also doesn't make much sense, but he is confident that he will be able to speak English within the next 6 months. Okay, so option D is the right one, and if you see, both the blanks suits the suit are for the option D. All right, so option D is the correct one, right? Clear to everyone? So after every question, I'll ask if this is clear or not. So quickly and please respond me. Okay? Yes, clear to all? So the next question is, his knowledge of the subject was excellent, but his classroom performance was dash. See, now we are looking for a word which is opposite of excellent, and this is how you're going to tackle these questions. Opposite of excellent. See, excellent means very good, right? Very good to the next level is excellent. So what we'll have is we'll have poor or very poor. Okay, so B doesn't satisfy. It is good, which is not opposite of excellent. Desirable also, desirable is okay. Okay, it's acceptable. No. Praiseworthy, again, it's a positive word. No. So we are looking basically for a negative word, and that means option A is right, and hence extremely poor would satisfy the sentence, right? Okay, so if you have any doubts, please tell me. Let's move to the next question now. Okay, so the next question is, let me just rub this off. Okay, so select the word that fits the analogy, right? Select the words that fits the analogy. Now they are saying cook and cook. So basically, it's not like they are saying two words. You just put A is to A. And see, this is nothing but a proportion question, right? If you have studied ratio and proportion in mathematics, so whatever relationship is there between cook and cook, same relationship should be there between fly and the other one. See, a cook is a person also. Okay, so if somebody is making food at your home, you will call him a cook. Okay, and what he is doing basically with the food, he is cooking or he cooks food. So cook will cook the food, right? It might be little, confusing, but that's what the relationship is. Okay, now fly, and the next person, the person who flies is called a flyer. Okay, flying will not make any sense because this is a relationship with the fly thing only. We are not looking for that. Flew also will not make any sense. Same flighter also will not make any sense. Okay, because someone who flies something is called a, or someone who flies is called a flyer. Okay, so option A in this case would be right. So if you have any doubts, feel free to ping in the chat. Okay, let's move to the next question now. All right, okay. So now it's a big sentence. It's a big statement. So here, see, in these kind of questions, what you have to do is always, always read the paragraph, okay, and try to get a sense of what the paragraph is saying. Okay, what is the you can say issue in the paragraph? There will be some issue highlighted. Okay, so I'll not read the paragraph. I've already read it. Okay, so if you see this paragraph, what they are saying is there are some issues because of, you know, melting ice, because of global warming and all. And they are saying the last statement, if you see, given this situation of imminent global exodus of billion of people displaced by rising seas, national states or nation states need to rethink the carbon footprint for political reasons, not for environmental. Okay, so what they're saying is, the summary is, the nation states want to rethink, okay, are we emitting too much carbon or not, okay, or the what is the carbon footprint in the whole world, okay, and that is because of political reasons, and the reasons are because people are moving from their current position. Okay, so displacement, law of displacement is there because of rising seas. Okay, so let's check at the options. So what can be inferred? Basically, what is the summary from the paragraph? Nation-wise, do not have environmental concerns. See, the author is saying that environmental ones are not required, but nobody is saying that the nation states have environmental concern or they don't care about environment. Okay, neither of the two statements are confirmed in the paragraph, so we cannot comment. So option A will be wrong. Some information which is not presented in the paragraph, you will not assume that, okay, no, this is right or wrong. Okay, never do that. Whatever is in the paragraph, just assume that to be right. If I say 1 plus 1 is 2, or if I say 1 plus 1 is 3 in the paragraph, for a moment think 1 plus 1 is 3, everything else is false. Okay, just remember that. Okay, so nationwide doesn't think false. Nationwide are responsible for providing fresh water. Where does the paragraph mentions fresh water? Nowhere. So option B is also rubbish. Billions of people are responsible for man-made emissions. See, yeah, this statement in fact will be true in general sense, but responsibility on people is not mentioned anywhere in the paragraph. Maybe few industries are responsible, who knows what happens. Okay, so if it is not mentioned, we'll not do it. Okay, billions of people are affected by melting glaciers. This is correct, because that is why they are being displaced, right? That is why they are being displaced. So if you see, option D is right. I hope this solution is also clear to everyone. And many students think that this solution or this question is from verbal. Okay, it is not from verbal. Remember, this is from logical reasoning. Okay, so don't say that, sir, I was not good in verbal, so I did not attempt this question. This is from logical reasoning. All you have to do is find out what information is presented in the question and what information is not given in the question. Okay, all right, so let's move to the next. If you have anything to ask, please ask me. All right, thank you. Okay, so see, as you all are computer scientists and all, so this question is basically similar to your single source shortest path. Okay, so I think now you'd be very comfortable. Okay, so all they are saying is, which is the cheapest route from 1 to 2. Okay, so one way is what? See, since the options are given, let's utilize the options. 1 to 2 from A to C, let's calculate the cost. So 1 to 2 from A to C is 100 plus 100 plus 100. So this cost is what? This cost is 400. Okay. 1F B2. Okay. 1F is 100. F2B is 0. And B2 2 is 100 plus 0 plus 200, which is 300. So option B is 300. Okay. 1B2. So 1 to B is 300. And B to 2 is 200. So this cost is 500. Alright, 500. 1FE2. So 1FE2. So 1 is this. And 1 to F is 100. F to E is 100. And E to 2 is 200. So 100 plus 100 plus 200 is 400. So if you see, these are the four cost. And this is nothing but single source shortest path. Single source shortest path. And since everyone is from CS, I don't have to tell you that, right? Because that is one of the basic algorithms you'll study in algorithms, right? So if you see, B is the shortest, cheapest route. So option B is right. Option B is right. If you have any concerns, please tell me. So I'll just give you 10-20 seconds. till five. I think we have completed five questions. Any doubts to anyone in any of these questions? Come on, guys, don't be lazy. I know it's morning, everyone is feeling sleepy, but let's wake up and solve these beautiful questions. Yeah. Okay. So, the next question. The next question is what? So, again, this statement is given, and what they're saying is, what can be inferred from the statement? So, now remember, these are 2-mark questions. Okay. So, see. One statement is GST is imposed on the goods, on the production of goods and services. So here they are saying it is a destination based tax. So that means where the product is being consumed, over there it is being taxed. Production side, there is no tax. Okay. So statement A by this is incorrect. GST includes all indirect services. And if you see, it subsumes, means it includes all indirect services except few. So not all. That's why option B is also wrong. Now let's check out option C. Option C is GST does not have a component specific to UT. And if you see here, GST has component specific to state government, central government and UTs as well. So we have this. So definitely C is not the right answer. And you will see D is the right answer. But I'll check D also. See, GST is imposed at the point of usage. That's what I said in the beginning, right? It's a destination based tax. So GST is also is imposed at a point of usage of goods and services. Okay, so option D will be correct in this case. All right, so let's move to the next question now. Okay, so now this is a logical puzzle, right? Okay, so P is 3, R is 27 and T is 243. Now see, I always tell people or I always tell my students to remember the powers. They are very important in recognition. Okay, this is 3 power 1. This is 3 power 3. This will be 81. 81 is 3 power 4 into 3. So 3 power 5. Right? These are the things. Now see, if I write P, Q, R, S, T. So this is 3 power 1. This is given as 3 power 3. And this is given as 3 power 5. So the middle ones are what? This is, imagine this is like a GP series, right? So this has to be 3 power 2 and this has to be 3 power 4. So in this way, you can obtain your value of Q and S. Now they are saying what is Q plus S. So 3 power 2 is Q, which is 9. 3 power 4 is S, which is 81. So if you add them, you will get 90. And like this, okay. Okay, so basically 9 plus 81 would be 90 and like this C option would be correct. C option would be correct.
Okay. Just
one second. So let's try to attempt this problem. This was also a very good question given, and of course these aptitude questions were in multiple branches. Okay, so what they are saying is this is a some annular ring which is given. You have inner circle, you have outer circle. Okay, so they are saying this portion which is left now over here, I've painted these circles. Okay, I've painted these circles. So what they want us to find the area, this area, this area which is remaining now. So let me highlight this area that they are talking about, this area which is not painted. We are talking about this particular area. Okay, so let's see how to find this. So first of all, let me try and find the area, whole area of this ring, this whole ring. Okay, the ring part. So this will be what? So area of the bigger circle minus area of the outer circle, so the inner circle, so that will be pi a square minus pi b square, because a is radius of the inner circle, b is radius of the outer circle. Yeah, okay, this is one thing. So okay, b square minus a square, I think I wrote it in the other way. So the area would be pi b square minus pi a square, right? Because A is the inner, B is the outer. So you subtract bigger one minus the smaller one. Next thing is what? Now let's calculate what is the area of this one circle. Okay, so area of this one circle would be what? See, now what is this length? This length would be equal to B minus A, right? This length would be equal to B minus A. Okay, so this, if I take up this circle, this length is b minus a. So the diameter is b minus a. So the radius is what? B minus a by 2. This is the radius of the smaller circle. Okay, or the smallest circles, the circles which are being painted. Okay, so what is the area? So the area is pi b minus a whole square by 4. This is the area of one circle. And they are saying we have maximum of n circles like this. We have maximum of n circle like this. So this area is the area of the, sorry, this area, oh my bad. Okay, this area is area of the whole annular part. Okay, this part, right? And then you have to subtract the area of the painted circle. So this will be n times of pi b minus a whole square by 4. Okay, you have to subtract this part also. So now this particular area, whatever this area will be the area of the region which is left unpainted. Area of the region which is left unpainted. Okay, so if you see, option B A really matches with the answer. Okay, option B is, I don't have a 4 over here, so wrong. This is plus, wrong, and no 4 and a plus, both wrong. So B, C and D are wrong and A is right. All right, so let's move to the next question now. So if you still have any doubt, guys, please make sure that you respond on the chat box. Okay. So two straight lines are drawn perpendicular to each other in XY plane. If alpha and beta are the acute angles that the straight lines make and so on. Okay. So basically these are two, some lines are drawn and these are perpendicular to each other. Okay. Something like this, perpendicular to each other. Now what they're saying is you're drawing straight lines and they make some angle with the x-axis. Right? So something like this. This is your x-axis. They make some angle with the x-axis. And now this angle and this angle are to be considered. Reason is, see, this is one thing they are mentioning. Acute angles. We need acute angles. So I need to consider this angle and this angle. Okay? Now, since I want to consider these two angles, so what I'll have is this angle, let's say this is alpha and this angle is beta, right? And now this is a triangle being formed. Okay, this angle is already 90 because they are intersecting at 90 degrees. So this is alpha, this is beta. So you can say alpha plus beta plus 90 degrees is equal to 180 degrees, because sum of three angles of a triangle is what? 180. So alpha plus beta is equal to 180 minus 90, which is what? 90. So option B is correct. Yes. Any doubts to anyone? Any doubts? Okay. So let's move to the next question. I hope whatever is being covered is clear to all of you. Let's move to the next one. Okay. All right. So here what they are saying is some graph is given and this graph is revenue for 1 year. Okay. Per year, what is the revenue that is given to you? And they are saying every year the expenditure of the company is 500 million rupees. Okay. Every year the expenditure of the company is 500 million rupees. Right. So now what you have to do is, they're saying aggregate profit. That means over the 5 years, from 14 to 18, over the 5 years, what is the total profit that the company got? Okay. So total expenditure will be what? See, 500 million rupees, but it is for 1 year. So 5 years would be 5 into 500 mil. Okay. So this is 2500 million rupees. Okay, this is total expenditure. Total revenue we can calculate. Total revenue would be, see, 500 in 14 plus 700 in the other one, then 800 in the other one, then 600 in the other one, and then 400 in the last one. So if we add these, so 12 and 8 is 2000, then 1000 is 3000, right? 3000 million is your total revenue. So yes, profit. Profit is what? 3000 minus 2500. So this is what? 500. 500 mil. Okay. Now, see. So like this, your B option and D option is wrong. So we have to check whether A and C, which is correct. So now profit percentage is what? Profit upon the total revenue or cost price. If you remember, in profit and loss, profit percentage is profit divided by cost price into 100. So 500 divided by 2500, which is the expenditure or the cost price into 100. So this and this will cancel by 5. This and this will cancel by what? 20. So this will be 20% profit. Okay. Now in this is the answer. So option C is correct. Okay. Now if you don't use this formula correctly, and if you write 5,500 divided by 3,000, which is the revenue. Okay. Revenue is like the selling price. Okay. This will give you the wrong answer. And that's why they have given you option A as the trap option. Option A is also given you as the trap option. So please make sure that you don't fall into these traps. All right. So I hope this is also clear to you. So let's move to the next question now.